some compounds smell really good. Because of the chemicals they contain, cinnamon and vanilla have a pleasant odor that you might call aromatic. When an organic chemist uses this word, they're likely referring to aromaticity, which is a special feature of some compounds. Now, I don't want to imply that all molecules with aromaticity smell good. Pyridine is an aromatic compound with an unpleasant, fish-like odor. And this aromatic pyridine salt has no scent at all. Additionally, compounds that are not aromatic can have strong odors. So if aromaticity isn't tied to smell, how can we tell if a compound is aromatic? Let's begin by talking about benzene, the classical example of an aromatic compound. We can draw a resonance form for benzene where it looks like the double bonds have moved. But this isn't the whole story at all. There's a continuous system of p orbitals above and below the ring. The electrons are actually delocalized around the ring, circling around the pi system. An electron density map of benzene shows red hot spots of electron density where the pi electrons are concentrated. Although some benzene representations seem to have alternating single and double bonds, each bond is 1.39 angstroms long, which is between the length of a carbon-carbon double and single bond. This is due to the delocalization of electrons that we discussed, and it makes aromatic compounds rather stable. To be aromatic, a cyclic compound must have a continuous pi system and be planar. It must also satisfy Huckel's rule, having 4n plus 2 electrons in the pi system, where n is 0 or a small positive number. Now, compounds that contain 4n electrons in the pi system are particularly unstable and are referred to as anti-aromatic. We need to be able to identify aromatic compounds because they have unique reactivity. When an alkene is treated with bromine, the double bond acts as a nucleophile, forming a cation that is attacked by Br-. The end result is the addition of Br2 across the double bond. When benzene is treated with bromine, an iron catalyst is required because of benzene's stability. Benzene attacks bromine, but Br- does not add to the cation. The stability gained by the compound becoming aromatic again is so great that the intermediate is deprotonated instead, resulting in the addition of just one bromine atom. Let's explore some more examples of aromatic compounds. When n equals 0, there are 2 electrons in the pi system, and an example is the cyclopropenyl cation. If n equals 1, there are 6 electrons in the pi system, and benzene and pyridine are examples. Pyridine is a weak base because it has a lone pair that does not participate in the pi system. It sticks out perpendicular, or orthogonal, to the pi electrons. Orthogonal lone pairs can make bonds without disrupting aromaticity. So, this methyl-substituted pyridinium ion, like the pyridine salt we saw earlier, is also aromatic. Pyrimidine is another example. It has 2 orthogonal lone pairs and 3 double bonds in the ring making up the pi system. Pyrimidine rings are very important because they make up your DNA. The cyclopentadienyl anion is an aromatic 5-membered ring. The negative charge on carbon is a lone pair that can participate in the pi system. Building on this, pyrrole is also an aromatic compound. At first glance, it appears there are only 4 pi electrons. However, there is a lone pair on nitrogen that can participate in the pi system. Furan is also aromatic because one of the oxygen lone pairs contributes. Geometrically, the second lone pair can't join, so we have 6 pi electrons again here. This positively charged 7-membered ring is also aromatic. The carbocation is trigonal planar. The empty p orbital occupies the space above and below the ring, making a continuous pi system. When we get into 10-electron pi systems, things get a little more complicated. Cyclodecapentaene fits most of our criteria for aromaticity. It satisfies Huckel's rule and is cyclic with a continuous pi system. However, in order to be flat, it would need to have bond angles of 144 degrees, which is far from the normal bond angle for an sp2 hybridized carbon-carbon bond. So the strain overcomes any aromatic stabilization and this molecule bends. Okay, so what if we introduce some trans double bonds to relieve the angle strain? We run into a different problem here. Because the H atoms are now facing inward toward each other, they have steric clash, and this molecule is not planar either. But if the H atoms are replaced with a methylene bridge, the steric hindrance is eliminated, and this molecule is aromatic. Returning to our chart, this 8-membered ring with 2 nitrogen atoms is another example of a 10 pi electron aromatic compound. Because both nitrogen lone pairs are needed to complete the pi system, they have to be substituted with electron donating groups. If the groups are 2 electron withdrawing, the lone pairs are pulled out of the pi system. This molecule twists because aromatic stabilization can no longer overcome steric strain. This 9-membered ring is also aromatic, again provided that the nitrogen is substituted with electron donating groups and can contribute to the pi system.